My name is Tony Frederick, and today I'm here to talk about the evolution of anime. Japanese anime goes back as early as 1917. Japanese anime during this time period had no sound, and each frame was hand-drawn, eventually moving to paper cutouts or chiyugami. This stop-motion form of animation was ideal in that it was cheap and simple to use. In 1923, an earthquake hit in Japan, devastating the country and destroying the prints of almost all anime prior to. In 1933, the first talkie was created titled Chikara to Ono no Yono Naka. It was a change for the Japanese as animation styles were changing and chiyugami was seeing itself phase out. Each frame was hand-drawn and colored on a celluloid transparent sheet. This was more work and required more time to produce than its cutout predecessor. In 1945, World War II was at hand, and the Japanese would release films that were racially biased and violent. One in particular was Momotaro's Divine Sea Warriors. Even though it was a propaganda film, it was actually Japan's first animated feature-length film. In 1948, the first Japanese animation studio was founded. They would later become Toei Animation in 1956. 2 years later, the first color feature-length film was created called Hakujaden. This film was the beginning of Japanese animation films in competition with the likes of Disney. With that being said, I have to mention an influential piece of this was a man named Osamu Tezuka, who was a huge fan of Walt Disney's animations. Tezuka would borrow the large expressive eyes and rounded heads from Disney's characters. This would later become the definitive characteristic style of what is known today as manga. The 60s was probably the most important decade for the world of anime as it introduced the most revolutionary content in terms of multiple different genres and subgenres. Japanese were now beginning to focus on more thorough story-driven content. In 1979, Mobile Suit Gundam was released, and you would be surprised today to know that this series was not popular from its beginning. However, it gained a massive following, and not due to the show, but in the selling of toys and merchandise. The 1980s will mark the turn for Japan in animation. American studios were now hiring Japanese animators to create their content. Animations like G.I. Joe, Transformers, and Voltron were a few to gain popularity in the States. In 1984, Dragon Ball would be released, giving us a new genre, my personal favorite, the martial arts genre. There were many risks and changes that occurred in the 80s, but the most important that would come would be in 1989 with the release of Akira. It was Japan's hugest budget, 1.1 billion yen, or approximately $8 million. This decade would change the anime industry from a small one with limited funding to one that is now internationally successful with the ability to be experimental and different. In 1993, Dragon Ball Z was released. It became a hugely popular TV series and made a lot of money in terms of merchandise sales. Shortly later, Japan would begin to see a rise again from its decline due to the economy crash, and in 1995, Ghost in the Shell would be released and become a box office smash. Sailor Moon would be released a year later and would run for 5 years, selling over $1 million in merchandise. Perfect Blue in 1997 would be another unconventional huge film for animation, being known for how it deviated from the more traditional way of storytelling. Cowboy Bebop aired in 1998, but wasn't so popular due to its violent rating. Anime has indeed seen a numerous number of improvements over the years and has become, in my opinion, the best when it comes to animation style and storytelling. Their gritty approach to tackling ideas that can sometimes be considered risky and/or controversial is really where this genre shines and stands out among the rest. With addition to streaming platforms such as Netflix and Crunchyroll, anime has reached more audience now than ever before.